Hey friends, it's Azure Friday, and we're going to talk about one of my most favorite subjects, Azure App Service, with Byron Tardif. How are you, sir?
Doing good, and you?
App Service is like the powerhouse for me. I know for some people it's virtual machines, mm-hmm. but when it comes to platform as a service, I've got 19 or 20 different web apps, and they're all running on various flavors of Azure App Service.
Right. And the beauty of having a platform instead of a VM is that you don't get to worry about all the infrastructure. You don't need to worry about updating, applying patches, any of that. You just focus on your code, use the tools that you're familiar with, and focus on what you need to do.
Yeah. The thing that I thought was interesting about App Service, and once I got my head around it, it became really powerful, was mm-hmm. the reminder that there's the App Service, which is like a web app or mm-hmm. whatever, mobile app, and then an App Service plan.
Correct.
Which is kind of like a VM, but you don't really think about it like a VM.
Right. It's the way that we basically separate your code from what is running your code. So the App Service plan, you can think of it as your computer in the cloud. The only difference is that this computer can go to 10 instances or 20 instances as you need for scale.
Right. It's not a virtual machine that I remote into or right. SSH into. So for example, in the West US, I've got a small.
Right.
I could also have a basic, but I wanted mm-hmm. a small because it has more features. And I've got, I think, 19 on that one, or 17 or 18, a lot. Like,
right.
I run it pretty hot.
Right. Yeah, you can run multiple different apps, depending on all on how much memory you're using and how many of them are running at the same time. But you can create, 10, 20 different apps, as long as they're not all running at the same time. They all can share one App Service plan. So if you're doing small hobbies type of stuff, it's very easy to throw everything pretty much in there.
Yeah, I haven't had any issues at all. Maybe you could make one for us.
Sure. To create a web app, it's very easy. You just go to basically the create on the portal. Oops. Just go to the create on the portal, and you're going to find it right here. It's one of the most popular things that people go create. And once you drill in, you'll notice that we not only have Windows, but we also have a Linux offering. Hmm. So you can, if you're basically working with open source platforms, they tend to run better on Linux. People prefer to run them on Linux, things like Python, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So you get the option to choose one or the other.
Okay, and then once I've set the App Service plan at this point to either Windows or Linux, mm-hmm. then all of my websites that sit on top of it then inherit that. They all become
right.
Linux.
So let's go through and create one.
Sure.
I'm just going to call this BK Azure Friday. And you can see here that I'm putting it in an existing App Service plan that I already had created before, but you can also go and create a new one as needed. Mm-hmm. When I click Create, this is going to take 30 seconds, and then you're going to have a completely new app that then you can go and publish content to. Mm-hmm. If we look at, I had a couple of apps that I had already created here in the dashboard, and we can take a look, and we can see that there's sitting on this App Service plan, and I can go take a look at the App Service plan, and I can see that I can have multiple apps running on that App Service plan.
Right.
So it gives you an idea of the relationship between apps and App Service plans.
And it might seem obvious initially, and obvious mm-hmm. to us since we spent some time with it, but once you get your head around that an App Service plan can have N number of App Services,
right.
you can have all kinds of fun. And then, of course, App Services can have slots.
Right. Yeah, that's the very next thing that people look at, is once you create an app, you can create what we call deployment slots. So depending on what plan you're using, you can have 5 or 10. And deployment slots are very practical when you're doing things like automated deployments. Mm-hmm. So for example, one of the features that the platform gives you is the ability to automatically deploy code every time you push stuff to things like either VSTS or GitHub or Bitbucket. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to have that code go directly to your production, right? Because maybe not all programmers are perfect. We sometimes develop bugs and we throw them in there. So having the staging slot update automatically makes it very natural for people that are doing agile type development. Mm-hmm. Because you can check in, git push, your website is updated by the time you go in, look at it in the portal, and you can do that last mile validation.
Yeah.
The next thing that the staging slot lets you do is it lets you do a swap. So without having to redeploy your bits, so your bits never change. We do all of the DNS trickery and acrobatics to basically start routing new traffic into the staging slot when you do the swap, and basically all traffic drains out of the old instance.
Right, it's instant.
It's instant, yeah.
Yeah, it's really great because there's so many bits of flexible parts that you can plug into app service, and mm-hmm. I'll just use mine as an example. I've got my podcast. I've got a podcast called Hansel Minutes, mm-hmm. and I run it on app service, and I have Hansel Minutes hyphen staging.
Right.
And there's different ways you can deploy. I can deploy to GitHub, like you said, and a branch on GitHub mm-hmm. could become the staging slot.
Right.
Or I can push directly to App Service as if App Service was a Git repo itself.
Right. Yeah, so we have the option of doing what we call local Git, mm-hmm. which is basically hosting a Git repository for you directly on the app.
And then I'm also a member of a homeowners association, and they have a static website they want me to manage. Mm-hmm. Like you said, a small hobbyist website. Right. I don't need a whole app service for it. Turns out you support Dropbox.
Right.
Who would have thought it? So then the other homeowners, they just change the text in Visual Studio Code, and they save it, and I go into the Azure portal and say sync, and I deploy to Dropbox. Something I thought I would never do, I do it all the time.
Right, and that is kind of like one of the drivers for the app service team is making sure that we enable people to use the tools that they're familiar with.
Exactly.
Like you said, like you don't need to know anything about Azure, you don't need to know anything about the cloud to be able to use this.
Yeah, so I've got flexible deployment.
Right.
I've got N number of staging slots.
Right.
I can go in, I can do Python and PHP and .NET and Java and on and on. And I can mix and match within a single app service plan.
And also instance scale. Mm-hmm. You can very easily increase the number of instances that your app service plan is running on. Mm-hmm. And it's basically as fast as your code can go through the startup routine, that's as fast as you get instances.
Yeah, and that's a really good point that you bring that up, because I found that I had some code that was starting up quite slowly because I prime a cache. Mm-hmm. And then when I fixed that bit of code and made my startup faster, and then I prime the cache later, that actually made my app service experience better. So when my app is smart about the fact that it's in an app service, Azure and app service works better for me.
Right. The main thing is we want to have people moving into cloud development paradigms where you're starting to think about your application being a lot more stateless. Mm-hmm. Because that lets you take advantage of the parallelism, right? You can go and run it on 20 instances, and it doesn't matter if one goes away and comes back. If you're not doing anything that affects a specific instance in a very special way, mm-hmm. like making a stateful, you can get advantage of the economies of the cloud.
Yeah. Another thing with app service that made me really happy, and I was surprised as a person that has a small business on the side, is I'm just one person, and I made an app service in Asia, in Europe, in central US, and then I put a traffic manager in front of it. And I'm doing all of this in 5 or 10 minutes, and I think there's an Azure Friday video on this. Mm-hmm. And suddenly now, I have this big global stateless application at one URL.
Right.
And I did it myself in 5 or 10 minutes. This is the kind of stuff that would take a whole team of DevOps people a week.
Yeah. If you want to go into more details about high performance or high scale architectures where you want to go and do like multiple deployments, mm-hmm. We have a video that we can link in the description where I go over techniques and things that you want to look at when you're building those types of apps. But like you said, it makes it very easy. You don't need to go into complex network configuration. You just throw Traffic Manager. And the fact that App Service is a tier one service, meaning that every time that an Azure region comes online, mm-hmm. App Service is there.
Yeah.
Makes it so that you have, I think there's over 20 different regions in which you can deploy your app.
Yeah, it's everywhere that you want your business to be. A true story, I was going to Japan, and I wanted my little startup application to be in Japan. It was right there, and at the hotel, before I gave my presentation, I deployed to Japan, I added it to the traffic manager, and I had an app service instance running locally in the place I wanted to do business.
Right, and that is, you can be as fancy as you want with your code, but there's nothing that's going to give you those performance gains as being in the same geography.
Being next door.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you have another demo for me?
Sure. So one of the things that we can look at is what we were talking about, the deployment options. So it's very easy to go and configure, as you can see, all of these different providers. So what I've done is I have already configured an application that is just a very simple ASP.NET, .NET Core actually application, and mm-hmm. I have done a couple deployments. You can see that there's a couple of things here.
Looks like you're going from GitHub.
Right, I'm going from GitHub in this case, and let's just go take a look at the app. And this is going to be the first time that I'm visiting the app, so it might be a little bit slow when it loads.
So that's a cold start up right
there. It's a cold start right there. And this is basically just a very simple hello world.
Mm-hmm.
So because I'm very audacious, I'm going to do a live code edit here.
Ooh.
And I'm going to do, instead of hello world, hello Azure Friday.
All right.
And I'm just going to save this. And like I said, like I could push this directly from Visual Studio Code, but I'm going to use the GitHub client in Windows. And I'm going to do a description, commit to master, and push. And if everything is going according to plan, when I go back here to deployment options, I'm going to see that.
So you just pushed it to GitHub.
I just pushed it to GitHub.
And then GitHub makes a call over to Azure, doesn't
right.
it?
Right. There's a webhook that gets triggered.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a backend process that is part of the website that basically receives the call from this webhook and then basically starts the deployment process. Sometimes it takes a minute or two.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to just try and force it right now.
Okay.
And there we go. We see the new change coming in. So this is basically pulling all of the changes from GitHub.
Mm-hmm.
If it needs to do a build, it'll do a build right there on the back side of your web app.
Right.
If you
and
have
the app is still live.
The app is still live.
Out that checkbox indicates the app is still up and running and working just fine.
We can go here and hit it, and it's just going to run. Yeah. And now we can see the
looks
change.
Like it was too fast.
It was faster than us.
Yeah. And that's the kind of convenience that you get with App Service, and why,
right.
even though there's so much that we're excited about on Azure, and why I do Azure Friday and I talk about all these other things, but I keep coming back to App Service. It's my tier one. It's my go-to service for getting things done.
Right. And App Service won't solve all of your problems, but we do see it as a core piece that you're going to use whenever you're building out. Like, for example, if you have a bunch of images, you probably don't want to store them inside of your app. You can always use storage. Or if you have things that are going to be kind of like a functional, right, where you want to pay per interaction, you want to go use Azure Functions. But you can kind of like use App Service as the core of your application and have, you know, the use of the other different Azure services as needed, because you always want to use the tool that's better suited to your needs.
Mm-hmm. All right. I love App Service, and I appreciate you coming to talk to me about it. I am learning all about my favorite Azure service, App Service, here on Azure Friday.